In this video, we will be discussing the anatomy of the male Extatosoma tiaratum in full detail via dissection and microscopic photographs. Let's start with the dorsal external anatomy. We will first begin with a quick review of the structures and then move on to more detailed information. Starting from the top and making our way down, we have the head, which features two filiform antennae and three simple eyes. Remember that we are currently only looking at the dorsal structures, so we'll talk about the mouth parts and the compound eyes later on. And then, after the head, we have the thorax, which is separated into three parts, the prothorax, the mesothorax, and the metathorax, and includes the fore and hind wings. Moving further down the insect, we also have the abdomen, which is separated into nine segments and includes the anus and genitalia. Now let's get into more descriptive details about the dorsal external view, starting from the head. Each antenna has 23 segments, some smaller than others, the first and last four segments being the smallest. The whole antenna is on average 4.5 centimeters in length. The first segment of the antenna is called the scape, which is mounted into a specialized socket which enables the insect to move the antenna as a whole. The second segment is called the pedicle. This very small segment contains the Johnson's organ, which is a collection of sensory cells that detects motion in the flagellum. The remaining antenna segments, called flagellomeres, make up the flagellum. The entire antenna is covered with small hairs called sensory setae, which helps the insect locate its surroundings. The antennae are the most fragile part of the insect, so it's very common for them to break during the lifespan of the insect. Sometimes they will just get damaged slightly, and when the insect heals, it creates an abnormal growth, just like this example. Now let's talk about the three simple eyes called ocelli. Each of these eyes compose of a single lens and an extended retina. They each have a wide field of view of 150 degrees or more, and may have as many as 10,000 receptors. However, they are profoundly out of focus, with the retina much too close to the lens. This is because they are used as horizon detectors, enabling the insect to make fast corrections during flight. High spatial frequency clutter such as leaves and branches are removed from the insect's ocellar vision due to the defocus, allowing the receptors to respond to changes in the overall distribution of light in the sky. This finishes up the dorsal external anatomy of the head. Now we can move on to the dorsal external anatomy of the thorax. The first segment of the thorax is called the prothorax. The dorsal view of the prothorax is bare, containing no major structures. It is the smallest structure of the thorax, and both the prothorax joints that connects it to the head and the mesothorax are flexible. The flexible head joint allows the insect to freely move its head around for easier food intake and better vision. The flexible joint that connects it to the mesothorax enables the insect to be able to break and push out of their old exoskeleton during apolysis. For more information about the molting process, check out our video called The Complete Molting Process of the Stick Insect Extatosoma tiaratum. The link will be in the description. The mesothorax is a bit more interesting, as it contains two forewings. They are strengthened by many veins, and the whole wing is very small and covers the joint of the hind wings. Because of this, it is speculated that their major function is to protect this joint. The last segment of the thorax is called the metathorax, and it contains the long hind wings that are used for flight. It is the largest segment of the thorax, and the joint that connects it to the mesothorax is slightly flexible, but the joint that connects it to the abdomen is fused, which disables any movement. The hind wings contain many long veins, which gives the wing a sturdier structure, and helps the wing fold neatly when the insect is not in flight. This finishes up the thorax dorsal external anatomy. Now, let's move on to the abdomen. To get a better look at this part of the insect, I suggest removing the hind wings. The abdomen consists of 9 segments, which bear no spines whatsoever. Abdomen segments 7, 8 and 9 make up the genitalia and anus area. The anus is a triangular shaped structure which is usually dark in coloration, and it is located at the end of abdominal segment 9. Just at the bottom of the anus, 2 cerci can be observed. These act as sensory organs which help the male Extatosoma tiaratum get into position for copulation. The 9th abdominal segment is rather flexible and can be lifted up, revealing a light coloured circular pad. This is a suction pad, much like the suction pads on the feet of geckos. During mating, this suction pad is used to hold onto a lobe located on the ventral side of the female's abdomen, making it harder for the female to get away. Below this suction pad is the reproductive organs, which extend out during copulation. And that is where we finish talking about the dorsal external anatomy of the male Extatosoma tiaratum. Now we can move on to the lateral external view. Starting from the head, the lateral external view of the insect includes 2 large compound eyes, and the thorax includes the exocrine defense gland and 6 long legs. Moving further down onto the abdomen, the lateral external view also consists of 7 spiracles on both sides and the abdominal lobes. Now let's get into further detail. The compound eyes consist of thousands of tiny hexagonal tubes called ommatidia. Each has its own lens at the front and its own cluster of light-sensing cells at the back. The tubes form an interlocking carpet that wraps around the insect's head. The image formed is a mosaic, and each tube contributes one piece. The image they form is not as clear and detailed as a camera eye, but compound eyes do have a much wider field of view, which is useful in flight. This completes the lateral external view of the head, so we can now move on to the thorax. On each side of the prothorax is a small exocrine defense gland. This gland produces a toffee-smelling pheromone which is used to deter predators away. Female insects are able to produce a lot more of this pheromone when compared to males. This is because males have the ability to fly away from a threat, whereas females cannot. Therefore, females have to rely more on this pheromone to keep them safe. The prothorax also includes the forelegs. These legs are the second longest legs of the 3 pairs and have the smallest lobes. Each leg consists of a coxa, a femur, a tibia, 5 tarsals, and tarsal claws. Between the tarsal claws lays a suction pad to further help the insect grip the branches. The mesothorax contains the middle legs, which are the smallest pair of legs, but they have larger leg lobes compared to the forelegs. And the metathorax includes the hind legs. These are the longest of the legs and have the largest lobes. This completes the lateral external view of the thorax, which means we can now move on to the abdomen. Abdomen segments 1 to 7 consists of a spiracle on both sides, making up a total of 14. The spiracles are the breathing apparatus of the insect and can be quite difficult to see on male abdomens because their abdomens are smaller in mass compared to females. Abdomen segments 4, 5 and 6 contain 2 abdominal lobes each, making a total amount of 6 lobes. These lobes act as camouflage and helps the insect blend into the leaves of trees. This finishes up the lateral external view of the male Extatosoma tiaratum. Now we can move on to the ventral external view. Briefly, the ventral view of the head consists of the mouth parts, which includes the labrum and labium, the maxillary pulps and labial pulps, and the glossa and the paraglossa. Moving down, the only structures that the thorax and the abdomen have ventrally are spikes. Now for further details about the ventral structures, starting from the head. The mouth of Extatosoma tiaratum has many parts. The labrum and labium of the insect are the upper and lower lip, and they help hold food in place when the insect is eating. The maxillary pulps and the labial pulps are used for manipulating food into the mandibles. Behind these pulps lay the glossa and the paraglossa. These act like the insect's tongue and enable them to taste food. And further behind these structures lies the mandibles. These are lined with sharp teeth called denticles, and they help cut and chew through plant material. Now let's move on to the thorax. The ventral side of the thorax of the male Extatosoma tiaratum is the most spiky bit of the body, consisting of an average of 18 spikes. These act as protection from predators. Last but not least, let's talk about the ventral view of the abdomen. Abdominal segments 1 and 2 also have spikes, but the remaining segments have none. This finishes up the external anatomy of the male Extatosoma tiaratum. Be sure to keep an eye out for part 2, where we will discuss in full detail about the internal anatomy.